I'm gonna steal your sunshine and I'll shit on your parade. Don't get me started on doing Michael Caine. My opinion matters, yours will fall in last place. I'm not shutting up and you'll be learning my name. Fifth in the family, but first in my mind. 1 out of 10, but I'm ranking just fine. We've only got now, there's no afterlife. Look, mom and dad, I'm just speaking my mind. Everything's coming up Kyle tonight. Everything's coming up Kyle tonight. Everyone's coming on Kyle tonight. Wait, what? No, nobody's coming on Kyle tonight. Everything's coming up Kyle tonight. You can't shut this mouth, but you're welcome to try. I only stop talking.
And we are live with season 5, episode 14 of Kyle Moco. Shut up. It'll get fixed by the time anybody's watching this. Welcome to the show. I am your host, Kyle Moca.
Hey.
Joining me, as always, is Mr. Justin Olimpado. How are we doing today, brother?
I'm good.
How are you? Is that other camera frozen right now?
I think it's blinking.
Is the other camera blinking? Well, it is blinking because we are joined on time by Mr. Zachary Storman. He's being extra creepy with that pop. You're a real creepy daddy this week. You're a real creepy daddy. You're really look in that camera. I'm just gonna say this. You really look like a young Saint Nicholas right there. Yes. Saint Niklaus. Saint Zach Niklaus.
Niklaus.
Just
Nicole
a fun Nicholaus.
That is my middle name.
Nicholaus.
Nick Holhouse?
Your middle name is Nick Holhouse?
Yeah, I'm really.
We didn't bring that up to Tim.
Yeah, I'm really.
What the hell? All
right, guys. My middle name's his cousin.
We have a really awesome show for you today in that we are going to be going through our entire Christmas discography, including two brand new songs. It's the first time, I think, at least the first time in a long time, that we're having two songs premiere on the same night. I think episode 1 of season 2, we did the rap battle response, and then we had Otis play.
And I had that candy song, too.
Oh, yeah, the candy song.
We did have
so it's not unprecedented. We've done this in the past, but also making this an extra special episode is we have no featured music, but we do have a featured performer, player of ours in the past going to be joining us at some point via Zoom, the meanest man in the world, Mr. Mark Miller.
And he comes and forces us every year to drink some goddamn eggnog.
Yeah, he makes us drink eggnog, and we don't like it. He just forces us to do it. So we got ourselves some nog, but we've got a lot of beer and shit that we're going to be drinking, too. But tonight, again, this is going to be a totally different episode than we usually do. We've done brunch radios in the past here and there, but this is our Christmas review. We've got 12 total songs. One of them recorded twice, and two of them are covers. So right. 11 individual songs, but I'll say Bitchin' Christmas 1 and 2 are very different.
They are.
And you guys are going to hear that if you've not yet heard it in the past. Right. So again, thank you everybody for joining us here live. If you're listening in the future, thank you for tuning in on whatever platform you are listening here. Usually I would, you know, start rambling and chatting about like weird and random little things, but we've got a lot of music to play today.
And a lot of beer to drink.
And we also have a lot of beer to drink. So I think without really any delay, we got to get into grading some beer. So hit it. What are we drinking?
We drink it so you don't have to. Run to you in the morning from the bathroom. Cheap foods and craft brews. Run to you in the morning from the bathroom. What are we drinking? What are we drinking? Yeah!
All right, well, Zach just pooped his pants, and we got a Kyle Kramer in the chat. Hey, Merry Christmas, you filthy animals, he says. Merry Christmas, you filthy, filthy bastard of an animal. I love you. I love you. Now, we have been going through and rating beers this season. We've been going back to a lot of classic light beers, and we've not yet
ever found this before. This is a rare case.
This is a very rare case here of Coors Light. I'm just noticing that my Rockies are not blue, and it's been in there. Do the cans activate? Are the
cans supposed to activate?
Okay, these don't go blue anymore, but they're still telling me they're as cold as the Rockies.
I bet you something with these change color.
Maybe. I'm going to put my thumb on it and see if it gets lighter, and then we'll look back in a couple of seconds. Now,
we appreciate you.
Thank you, Kyle. I always like people named Kyle because it's easy to remember their names. Because it's my name. But yeah, we've got Coors Light here. I generally avoid Coors Light most of my life, but then we started hanging out with, you know, like at like Patty's. Patty drinks Coors Light, and once in a while there'll be the accidental beer that is opened at sure. the bar, and they're like, I'm done with work, and they're like, hey, we got a mistake, you can just drink this. And I'm like, yes ma'am, I will do that. I don't hate Coors Light, and I feel like if it is as cold as the Rockies, if you're drinking it appropriately cold, you don't really taste too much of it.
No. It's good in the summer. I don't never really order it.
Yeah. Yeah, this is the first time in a long time that I've ordered or purchased a 30-pack. The only other time I remember doing that was when it came in that big bag that you use for, like, wires and stuff now, that the cooler bag. Those were cool.
Yeah.
They would have been cooler if they had a better
they
beer.
They still do those.
And they still do that. It's a cool thing that they do. Now, for you guys, Justin, you say you don't really reach to it. Was there ever a point where Coors was a drink of choice for you in your life?
Probably during the Country Club. There was a lot of people that just drank Coors. So if you were around them, there was a good chance you were drinking Coors. Yeah, like somebody in some group always drinks Coors.
Yeah, and it's like, yeah, there's always the person that drinks Miller. Mean Mark right. Miller drank Miller all of the time when we used to hang out at Floods back in the day. And I just remember being like, yeah, like what? Well, like if I was going to go for a light beer, I'd just be like, yeah, just get me what he's drinking.
Right.
And I'll go with a light beer. So I generally tend to lean towards the Miller Lights of things. We've already established in the past that we secretly all love Bud Light if we don't know it's Bud Light. Yes. But Coors is the one I probably shit on the most. Zach, do you have any personal history experience with Coors? That
my grandfather on my dad's side was a Coors Light man.
Coors Light. Now, do you prefer Coors Banquet over Coors Light in your head? Like, if you had the option?
In my head, I do,
yeah.
I think
it's
better.
It's
a fuller taste.
Yeah.
Although, the Coors Light in the bottle's far superior.
Oh, yes. It's very smooth.
I've been kind of keeping it with the cans to kind of keep them as fair as possible because we started with cans and we're gonna continue with that. And most things are available. You can't get hams in a bottle. I've never seen hams in a bottle. But we're sticking with the cans here. Now, like I said, it's kind of just water. Like, you're not really getting too much of a flavor off of anything. But if you're telling me that you want a low-calorie, low-carb, light beer, you can't really go much lighter and much better. It's just a light.
It's just a beer.
It's just a light beer. Yeah. I don't think it's a lager in any way.
To be a light pilsner? Is that what
maybe a light pilsner? Yeah, that would make sense if it's kind of going in the same vein as the Miller Lite side of things. But this isn't triple hopped, you know, like fair that enough. Hoppy ass Miller Lite that they got. Yeah. I appreciate it. I can enjoy it. I like it. I don't love it. I'm probably gonna give this one of the lower grades that I have given any beer. I'm going to give it a 52.
Okay.
It's just middle of the road. It's a little bit above dead center.
Right.
I like it maybe less than I like regular Budweiser, maybe a little bit more. It kind of goes back and forth, but it's, if it's cold, and we'll see as the night goes on, as these get a little warmer sitting out, if my rating goes down. So I'm going to give it a 52. Justin, what do you think? Scale of 0 to 100.
I'm going 48 on this one. It's a little, there are middle-of-the-road beers that we've rated at 50, or at least I've rated at 50.
Yeah.
I think Miller Lite was one of them.
Yeah, Miller Lite actually had a decent ranking, I think. I can look that up, and I'm not going to.
But, yeah, it's just under that middle ground.
Okay. Yeah, you're a little below. I'm a little above. Zach, what do you give this? You, again, familial history with this. Your paternal grandfather was a Coors Light man.
I have bought case of Coors here and there, Coors Light.
Yeah.
And then
it's poundable, man. It's just a poundable beer. Yeah.
I gotta go. 47. Average.
So we're going to wind up, just doing quick math in my head, we're going to wind up right about a 48 and a half on this one. Yeah. So that is going to be below average, and I think that puts it below Budweiser overall.
Yeah,
it's going to be fun at the end of the season to go back, and what I think I'm going to do is ask you guys, based on memory, what would you rank this beer, and then we can compare what our memory is to that. To see, like, when, like I said, if you hand me a Coors Light and I drink it, I'm like, whatever, it's not offensive. But if you say, hey, do you want a Coors Light? I go, no, I'm all right. You got anything else?
Right.
Yeah, I mean, like, if it's Coors Light and Corona, I'm going Coors. If it's a hot-ass day in the middle of summer and those are my two options, I'm going Coors, because I don't need an accessory lime to be thrown in there to make it taste the way it's supposed to be tasted.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know. It's not that great. It's not that bad. It's just middle of the road. So let us know what you guys think. If you're a Coors Light fan, tell us to go fuck ourselves, all right?
Yeah. Middle of the chode.
Middle of the chode. Now, we were talking about this the other day, how we should have done like a 12 Beers of Christmas, and then we walk into the beer distributor today, and they have the 12 Beers of Christmas, a little variety pack that Zach is sitting on over there. Yes. Now, Zach, before you pop that open, can you give a little read-through on the one side? I don't know if it's on both sides. There are 12 different styles of beer. We're going to kind of go with whatever order it comes out of the case in, but is there any of them there, because we both, Justin and I, had a chance to look at it, anything there that you are expecting to really like or hope to really like based on the names in there?
It's a good mixture of IPA.
There's a good, stout. It's about half IPA.
There's different. A Belgian quadruple.
That's what I was hoping you were going to look
with
at.
With the pumpkin with the Santa hat.
Yeah, that, it's going to be weird. That one's going to be weird.
The Bavarian IPA.
Yep.
That's interesting.
And they got a black IPA in there as well, I believe. Is this a black IPA? Or
yeah. There's a double black IPA.
Yeah, it's going to be... We're going to be a little tipsy. Now, we only have one of each because we didn't buy three 12-packs of this thing because they only had one of them. So we had our little tasting cups.
We're each still going to drink four...
Four high-octane beers.
Yeah.
We're going to be fucked. Which is why, again, Coors is a great accompaniment. If you're doing beer and shots, I can understand why you drink Coors Light.
Now, will you real quick just read... Where they go, because it goes 1, 2, 3. You don't have to do it in that order, but on the side of the box, will you read what 1 through 12 is? What they recommend is the first through the 12th.
This is their recommendation.
Oh, this is the order you're supposed to do it in?
Apparently, but we're just going to do it in whatever order it comes out.
However you want.
Yeah, your choice. You got a job
today. Double dry hopped. Yeehaw.
Nice.
Space cake.
Nice.
Nope, I already fucked the order up. I gotta read this one.
Yep.
Double dry hop, yeehaw, IPA, Reindeer Games, Bavarian IPA, Pecan Pop Porter.
That one I'm excited
Space
for.
Space Cake Double APA. Space.
Double APA?
Yep.
American Pale Ale, that's
Royal,
what that is.
Royal Standard Wee Heavy Ale. I like don't know those. What that means.
A Wee Heavy? Ooh, it's a bit heavy.
Bubble Farm. Bubble IPA. Bubble.
Bubble.
Bubble Farm.
Bubble
Farm.
Bubble butt.
Chocolate Sombrero. Mexican Stout.
Yep.
That, if that has a little bit of cinnamon, like that Mexican, really good. Oh, that would be good.
I hope it's like a mole.
A churro in a glass.
Eagle Claw Fist IPA.
It's that's good a, names that's a, on this guy.
A school of karate technique, if I ever heard one.
Oh, yeah.
Eagle, I practice Eagle Claw Fist.
Straight out of Kentucky. Eagle Claw
Straight
Fist.
Straight out of Kentucky.
Yeah.
The One Man Holiday Quadruple.
All right.
Advent Party Crasher, which is an Imperial Stout and has like a anime werewolf picture.
Yeah, the cat
Advent
be fun.
Party Crasher is anime werewolf.
All right.
Look out.
Anime werewolf.
Happy Feet, which is a black IPA.
Okay.
And Galactica.
Galactica. All right. It's just
and
another
it's from,
IPA.
All from Clown Shoes.
Yeah, it's all from Clown Shoes is the brewery. So Zach is going to open them, and we have 12 songs and 12 beers. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to extend what are we drinking throughout the entirety of this show, pretty much. Zach's going to pick at random. If he wants to go in order, he can do whatever he wants. And we are going to crack open the beer. We're going to maybe give it a sip or two before the song starts. We're going to talk about it maybe a little bit. And then we're going to play a song, and then we'll come back and give our grading after we listen to the song. So, Zach, if you'd like, pick your first one out of here. If you want to, again, however you want to do it. Random, not random, what are we going with?
Double Dry Hop Yeehaw's number one beer on
all
the
right.
list.
All right, it's number one beer on the list. So we got the little tasting cups. We're going to pass the can around, and we're going
to
give it a little sipper.
To the left hand side.
So realistically, we're all getting 4 ounces of a beer.
Yes.
Just make sure you pour it appropriately, because otherwise you're going to wind up with a shitload of head. And there's only certain times that you want a shitload of head. And usually in the bedroom and with, like, Guinness. I always like a lot of head with Guinness. Guinness head is just nice and extra frothy. All right, so now our first song that we're going to be playing is Bitchin' Christmas. Now, Bitchin' Christmas is a single that we recorded twice. This is a song that we recorded with Mr. Mean Mark Miller, who will be joining us at some point.
You got way more.
Yeah, there's still a little bit in here if you want a little bit more.
Now I got to know how much to pour because I got, like, nothing
over
there.
You got, like, nothing in there. Ah, reaching.
Here, take some more of this, dude.
You boys drink your fucking beer.
We're gonna drink our beers.
Cheers.
Now, do you guys remember recording Bitchin' Christmas the first one around?
Yes, I do.
Because we had a guest on it, I feel like we remember that one a little bit more. I thoroughly enjoyed the idea that we were gonna do a rockabilly Christmas song, and that was the approach, and we did it in 2018, 3 years ago. And then, well, 2 years ago, technically, and three numbers ago. That was fucking me up earlier. I'm trying to go, like, how many Christmases is it ago? And I'm just like, it's three Christmases, but that's 2 years. And my brain was all fucked up. Last night's holiday party really didn't help me. I was kind of worse for the wearing this morning. But we redid it again in 2019. So what we're going to do is we're going to play the first one, and then we're going to come back, talk about it, and then we're going to jump into the second one. At some point, Mark is going to join us. Do you remember liking one or two better? Did you like one better
only because I don't like the drum, how the drums came out, or how I played the drums
on the second,
one. If we could go back, I would like to redo it again.
Again?
Yes.
Which we will one day, and it'll be the only song that we ever let Mark record with us. He kind of is like, yo, guys, like, you go and you record, like, Screamo-style songs and, like, heavier shit. I can play that, too. Why am I only playing rockabilly music with you? And I'm just like, stop being such a dickhead. Why are you so mean about this? But all right, let's get right into it. Here it is, our first ever Brunch Weekly original Christmas single.
I like this beer, by the way.
Bitchin' Christmas. I'm gonna take a sip, and we'll come back and communicate on how we rate it.
Yeah.
Hit it.
Gonna be a bitchin' Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some trash tonight. It'll be a bitchin' Christmas, honey. You and me by the bathroom light. Gonna hop my wheel. Gonna pick up my gown. It's pedal to the metal. Christmas time to raise hell. Yeah! All the kids singing carols with the kids. We've got better plans. Gonna be a busy Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy Christmas, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. Your friends all went to service. Christmas Eve candles alive. Sipping eggnog with their grandma. We got a front bench seat, speeding off through the night. Gonna be a busy Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy Christmas, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. business, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. Tell your mom and papa, don't wait up tonight. You and your secret Santa, gonna drive hard to the morning light. It's Christmas Eve, I got the girl on my sleeve. Got a present for you, alright. Gonna be a busy Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy Christmas, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. Got one thing on my list of bitching Christmas with my number one bitch. I've got one thing on my list of bitching Christmas with my number one bitch. Christmas, baby, we're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy Christmas, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. Gonna be a busy Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy Christmas, honey. You and me by the dashboard light. It's gonna be a busy Christmas, baby. We're gonna make some tracks tonight. It'll be a busy
drink your nog. Well, drink again, nog. There you have it. That is Bitchin' Christmas, the original, the 2018 version. We were saying, Zach, while listening to that, you wanted to trim it down on the second one. We had a couple of we had a couple of little things like the drunken sailor part. Like, I think we cut that down a little bit on this upcoming version.
Yeah, just the pacing of it was off.
But I do think when I think of that song, that is the version that is in my head. And it has the wonderful laugh because you were just like, I remember you being like, just like kind of do something here at this one part. And it was probably the first point of me doing something like an improvised moment that actually went well in a song. And I was just like, I got one thing on my list of bitching Christmas with my number one bitch. And you just lost it.
Yeah.
And then we just kept that in there. And it was perfect. And I think it adds to the feeling.
When we started doing this, this was the first season that we started doing full songs, right?
Yeah, this is literally like our 10th song in, 12th song in, something like that, because we had done even less than that, because we had done October and November, and then we started these in December. Right. So, yeah, this is only a couple of weeks in. From a quality standpoint, it being one of the oldest song that we're going to be playing.
It's not the worst in quality.
It's really not bad. You can definitely tell that we've gotten better, and hopefully listening to the next one back-to-back.
Don't worry, Jeff.
You're going to be able to hear the exact same song, just a little bit different, right about soon.
Yes.
That's it on the song. I love it. It's one of my favorites. But we're going to be listening to it all over again, just a little bit different. Now let's talk about that beer that we just drank.
Yeehaw.
Weehaw or Yeehaw?
Yeehaw.
Okay, Yeehaw.
New England style IPA. It's a 7%.
It's a 7%er. I did not think it was going to be that high. I thought it was going to be like a nice 5%. This is nice and light and smooth.
That's why I like New England so much. It's not as hoppy.
Yeah, you get that juiciness with it. But I really like this. Scale of 0 to 100 for a 7%. I think I got to give this a 75. This is a good one. This is a good one. What are you thinking on it, Justin?
Going to 80.
80?
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, I'm thinking somewhere in the 76.
76. All right,
it's so juicy. It's juicy.
It's just really delicious. Now, before we jump into the next song, Zach, have you decided what our next beer is going to be?
Yeah, number two, Reindeer Game.
We're going in order. Okay. Is it in order in the box? No. Oh, it's not?
Okay.
I'm going to go in order until it gets The more I take out, the easier it is to find the next one. Okay.
That's true. That is true. Gotcha. Okay, so what does it say on this one? What's the ABV on this guy? Does it got that printed boldly
7%.
For you?
It's so, another 7%. All right,
another 7%. So we'll be able to compare it. Maybe our rankings are going to go down as we go, well, that wasn't as good as the last one.
Well, you have
one.
To also figure different styles. Like when we get into a double IPA, you know, like with our rankings, we try and keep them within what they are.
Mm-hmm.
So as a New England, that's very easy to
drink.
Yeah,
it's super, super easy. Now, that might be the easiest New England I've ever had.
Bavarian style IPA. I can't say I've ever had that before.
I don't think I've ever had a Bavarian style IPA. All right, so we're going to give this a pour and get that started to pass around.
Oh, very dark.
It's very dark.
Very dark. But while we're doing that, why don't we just jump right into the next song while we're getting that passed around. So now we've got our second version of Bitchin' Christmas off of our Christmas 2 album, again featuring Mean Mark Miller. He's playing the bass. I did not say that before. He's playing the bass on both of them and telling you to drink yo nog. Drink yo nog. What is Kyle saying in there?
He says you should always dig in the box so you get what you want. I thought that.
That's something Kyle would say. That is true. It's also something I would say, so that it's something Kyle's would say. All right, guys. So here we go. The second version, the 2019 revisited, I think we titled it.
Yes.
Here is Bitchin' Christmas. Jeff, you're just in time.
Hell yeah.
Enjoy. Bitchin' Christmas. So right off the bat, the bells really make that version.
Yes.
The bells make that version. It is much quicker. And then we took the slowdown. Instead of doing two separate slowdowns, we kind of just did one to end the song instead of it like going right back into it. But the bells and the piano, this is around where you started getting into playing the piano a little bit. Before we got really into you playing the piano.
I like everything else on the song except for my drums.
It does have... I think the drums are good. I think the cymbal level is just kind of like...
mashing the
hell out
of
it. Yeah, it's just like a little distracting through the whole thing. But other than that, it does have a much more prominent Drink Yo Nog in there. Yes, it has a very prominent Drink Yo Nog, and we really had to push that in.
I think you can probably hear Justin's... what cymbal, like how good the cymbals he owns are through, like, if you listen to beginning until now.
Yeah, the quality. Like, yes.
Oh, well, that guy just kept buying better cymbals.
Yeah. Better and different. And
the cymbals now, I'm very happy.
Oh, I love them. I think they sound great. Also, I can still mash the cymbals, but the way you have everything set up and the way everything is. Plus, I have a little bit more control in what I'm doing. So, like, when you're like, hey, it needs to be softer and quiet, it's like, okay, cool.
You know? Yeah, well, Jeff is saying that he loves the rock and roll of Billy rhythms. And thank you. Thanks. That's what we were going for and why Zach wanted to speed it up on the second version of it to really kind of kick it into overgear. It is literally a song about supposed to be driving around with your number one bitch, so it had to be a driving song. Now, to mention something else that Jeff brought up in the chat, Bavarian Indian? It's a Bavarian IPA. I don't know why it's Bavarian. Did you see anything on the bottle?
No, it doesn't
that says
say anything.
It?
I'm going to assume it's the hops that they use.
Okay,
though.
Yeah, Bavarian.
Or the way that they
brew. Why should it be an IPA? Like, what makes it India?
Well, the whole IPA thing, I think we've gone over this on the show in the past, but to reiterate, basically, they would make beer in England, and then they would ship it on a boat to India, but they would overhop it so that it didn't go bad by the time it got there, and then people just started drinking it in England, going, "Oh, this is just good like this." So it became an India Pale Ale. Yeah, I can't speak.
I remember now.
Yeah, I believe it's the hops because another one is Munches on Hops.
Okay.
By Devil's Backbone. We have seen this
bottle
before.
Do you like Devil's Backbone too? Very cool.
So that's a Bavarian IPA.
Now, another just really super easy beer to drink. I feel like we're going to just be loving these all the way through. It's got a little bit more of the bite to it because it's not the New England style. A little bit more hoppy, but still 7%. And it's pretty much, I'm going similar. I think I like the other one more. And not ever having any Bavarian style IPAs before, I didn't really know what to compare it to. Right. But I'm going to say, I'm going to drop it down a little bit. I'm going to give this one a 69 just because it's a fun number. Nice. But it's a 69, I would say, out of 100. It's pretty good. It's pretty damn good. I would drink more of these if we had more.
I'm going 75 on
75?
This
one. All right. Yeah. So dropping a little bit.
A little bit.
Zach, what are you thinking? So going up a little bit. You like this one a little bit more?
Just a hair. Just one tick more.
One tick more. There is almost a little bit more of a maltier flavor to it. Yeah. I don't know if that's with the sugars and the darkness of the actual color. But I think that's awesome. Now, what is our next clown shoes that we are jumping into? What pair are we jumping? What pair are we wearing?
Pie border.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited
now,
for this.
Wait till you see this. The art.
Yeah.
It's a samurai.
Okay.
Eating pecan pie with his hands.
Okay.
And how else do you eat pecan pie? Everywhere. Come
on. Oh,
but
and we have.
It's such a weird piece of artwork.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, do we have a
surprise? You got me?
Do we have somebody? I think we have somebody here. Oh, we're going to get this all configured.
Give me
to make
one
sure.
Second, but
we're
I got gotcha.
We're going to get you on camera, but we now have a Mean Mark Miller in the room virtually with us as we are pouring out our pecan pie porter. There he is. Oh,
hello.
That's a picture of
that's
Justin.
Me. No, wait.
Look. Oh, no. We lost Mark. Now we can just see Justin. There he is.
That's
hey,
all
buddy.
I see too.
Hey, how you doing? Can you see us now?
I kind of can, yeah. It's
kind of can. It's weird. Okay. Now, because of the world that we are currently in, Mark is not available to be here in person as he normally is for our Christmas episodes, which is unfortunate because we really, really wanted to make you re-record Bitchin' Christmas a third time. We were really hoping to get
I really
that going.
Wanted to.
Yeah. But now there he is. All right. Now he's on camera. You guys can see him. So, Mark, you
is
just
that,
had.
How's that? Is that better?
That works, brother. Now you just had a baby. Congratulations. Wow. Your first daughter. You had a girl. Congratulations. Yeah. Big ups to Mark and his sperm. Big ups to Mark's sperm. For making babies, and big ups to Beth's womb for baking them, because you guys making some, you're making an adorable family over there. But because of everything that's going on, you can't be here. But it is our tradition to have you on and for us to drink nog. We didn't get boozy nog; we just got regular nog. But we're going to give you a toast while we're sipping a lot of beer. So we're gonna save the nog toast.
Oh, you're saving the nog. Okay.
Oh, you can drink your nog. You
drink your nog. But we will toast.
But we're gonna toast to you at the end for sure.
I made myself two nogs out of expired nog.
Ooh. Have you sipped them at all?
I have. Not bad. It's rum. It's not Kahlua.
Okay. All right. I was expecting the bottle of Kahlua to still be in the fridge, and it must have been consumed at some point in the last year because it's not in the bottom shelf anymore. So who knows where that went. Now, Mark,
I know where it went.
I think we do, too. I think finished.
I can see where it went.
Yeah. Oh.
Fuck you, Mark.
I'm sorry. I love you.
He's wearing the hat you gave him and everything. You're such a dick.
I was trying to find one.
I could only find one. Yeah, I could only find one. We don't know where the others went to. But we just finished playing both versions of Bitchin' Christmas. To kind of reflect on them, do you ever go back and listen to them when it's not Christmas? Have you gone back and listened to either version fairly recently at all? Are they fresh in your mind?
Not very fresh, no. I'm sorry.
No, that's all right.
They haven't become Christmas classics in your home?
What the hell is
wrong?
No,
you know...
I take everything back I said about your family. Everything nice I said.
I'm sorry. We're trying not to teach the kids bitching.
Okay. All right.
No, not till they're 10.
Gotcha. I got to tell you, that's pretty bitching. It's pretty bitching of you. Now, you are joining us just in time. We've got you started passing around the pecan, right? That's the next one that we're going to be going on. So we're going to sip that over the next song. And the way we are set up, he is going to be able to hear the music, right?
Yes.
Okay. So Zach wrote, we wrote two songs today, and we were still done with both of them way early.
Yes.
Zach wrote a solo effort tonight based on, I'll let you tell it. Where did the brain baby here come from, and what are we all in for? What are we getting to hear tonight from
you? I was singing an Arcade Fire song in my head.
Yeah.
And then I started singing, like, Christmas, like, stuff over it.
Yeah.
And then I came upon the line, which is the title of the song, you could get fucked for Christmas.
You could get fucked for Christmas. Your kids will love this one.
Yeah,
when they're 12.
You know, not like a sex way. Like when you say to somebody, like, get fucked.
Get fucked.
You know what I mean? Like, everything is, the whole world is just fucked this Christmas. And it's about that.
It's about, the turmoil we are all going through. So Justin and I have nothing to do with this. We were downstairs while he was recording it. In the middle of him recording it, he took a phone call. He was like, all right, sweet, I'll see you tomorrow, and hung up, and I'm like, is that part of the song? I have no idea what you're doing up there. So what is all on here musically? You play acoustic guitar, you do some stomping and some clapping, and then you sing. Is that everything?
Bass.
You put bass on there. All right, so again, you can get fucked, or you could get fucked. What is it? You can get fucked?
You could get fucked.
You could get fucked
for Christmas.
For Christmas. So let's jump into it. And Mark, keep your ear out, because there is a little nod to you in the middle of this here. So
I'm trying to center myself. This is weird. Sorry.
I always just center myself by writing go-karts or masturbating.
What?
It's a deep cut there if anybody gets it. You rock. All right, so let's jump into You Could Get Fucked This Christmas, Zach Storman solo effort. Get fucked, people.
Get fucked.
I don't want to hear what you have to say. My ears have been closed since election day. But both the Senate and the House agree that you could get fucked for Christmas. Met some libtards and some right-wing nuts. Consensus is we're all fucked. Don't matter which side of the pond you're on, you can get fucked for Christmas. You can get fucked for Christmas. Might as well wait it out. 'Cause you can't go out. But now grandma's dead, 'cause you coughed in the bread, and you could get fucked for Christmas. You could get fucked for Christmas. Don't wanna kill around me. I wanna drink nog with Mark and his family. Everybody online is fucking slamming me. But you could get fucked for Christmas. Yeah, you could get fucked for Christmas. Might as well wait it out. 'Cause you can't go out. But now grandma's dead, 'cause you coughed in the bread, and you could get fucked. Gifts when you can't go to work. It's hard to do the right thing when everyone's a jerk. I wanna be a good boy, but God, it fucking hurts. I'm fucked. I'm fucked for Christmas. I'm fucked for Christmas. I'm fucked for Christmas. I'm fucked for Christmas.
There you have it. You could get fucked for Christmas, a Zach Storman solo effort, a Brunch Weekly original single, still nonetheless. While we were listening to that, the cat just like ripped ash right in my face. And I'm just sitting here like inhaling the cigarette. I'm like, it is fucking awful.
I just realized that you named yourself Mean Mark Miller.
Nice. Mean Mark Miller on the screen there. Fuck yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Legitimate now. So
Zach,
Mark,
that was great.
I was gonna say, what do you think? He wants to drink nog with you and your family and teach your kids terrible words.
I want you to
words.
Drink nog with my family.
Yeah, hell you yeah. know, it was about how this shit sucks.
Yeah.
But like, I'm trying to do the right thing.
Yeah.
It's hard though during Christmas time. You
it's really hard
mean?
to stay away from yes. everybody.
It's very difficult.
It yeah. sucks.
But I know that that's. You gotta do that shit. Otherwise, grandma'll be dead when you cough in the bread.
That's you true. Wrote this while you were splitting wood this afternoon, and your brother Nate went, "What are you singing?" And you went, "Oh, it's a song I'm writing right now." And then you just figured it out, and then you came home and you busted it out in like under an hour.
Under an hour.
I will say I like the secondary percussion of the mic stand rattling in the background at the end as you're stomping. It actually kind of worked in a weird way. What doesn't work in a weird way is the pecan pie. I don't like it. I also don't like pecan pie.
I love pecans.
Because pecan pie is amazing.
This does not remind me of pecan pie.
I can get fucked this Christmas. It reminds me of the way that I don't really want to finish it. That's how it reminds me of pecan pie.
I mean, I finished it. It's also an 8%.
It's 8%, but it tastes like grain alcohol. And it's like you pointed out, it's got a chemically taste to it. I'm taking a long time sipping on this.
Just chug it down.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to just down to the hatchet.
So that one was 8%.
Should be drinking this nog, man. It's smooth.
I might just chug the rest of this nog, or all of this nog, just to get that out of my mouth. Yep. That one is not good.
So what are you giving it?
I'm giving it a 30 for it's supposed to be a porter. I like porters, and it has nothing to do with the pecan flavor. I'm sure of it.
No, because I love pecan pie, and it doesn't remind me of anything.
I can enjoy the flavor of pecans. I don't really like the texture, and that's kind of where the pie kind of goes out the window for me. It's mostly pecans and molasses. What's
basically,
in it?
Yeah.
So, and I love me some molasses. It makes me slow. That and other things make me slow. And the pecan pie porter is going to make me slow.
Yeah.
It all works. I'm just slow. Did I say a rating?
35? 35,
that's pretty much where I'm thinking. Now, Justin, what do you get on this
one? Giving it a 40.
40? Zach?
Yeah. as a big fan of both porters and pecans, this was off.
Yeah.
22.
Mm-hmm. So sorry, Clown Shoes, you're losing your near perfect record here with us. But we've got another one to hopefully redeem it, and another song to go along with it. Yes. So what are we jumping into next over here?
Space Cake.
Double IPA. Okay. All right.
9%.
Oh, we're going up the percentage. Oh, no. Now, the song that we're going to be doing is one of my favorites of ours all around, not just Christmas songs. This is Protest the Santa. Protest the Santa is the brainchild of James O, a longtime friend and collaborator. He came up with the idea, and then we just kind of ran with it, and it was kind of the taking an allegorical tale for Amazon and other factory, like, warehouse workers that are just kind of like, fuck it, I want to overthrow the person in charge. But from the scope of it being elves bitching about the big fat guy, you know, the fat man. And we really give it to Santa in this one. And yeah. It has some of my best character work, I think. My Santa's pretty good. And the pitch-shifted elf is really another effort where I just, like, went in and improvised something for, like, 30 seconds. And it all just wound up making its way into the song. So, yeah, another short one here, because we are going to be getting to some long ones pretty soon. So, without any further delay, here is Protest the Santa from Christmas 2019 Christmas 2 album. Enjoy.
Don't need a list to prove that you're not nice. Even your missus says, oh, Nick's not gonna fly. This is our time. This is the day. Tear down old Santa from atop his sleigh. Trying to organize.
All right, everybody. Tonight's the night, all right. That piece of shit's going down. We've broken our back for too damn long with this motherfucker. He's going down.
The reindeer are so fed up with sawing your fat ass. You pushed us to our end. This Christmas will be your last.
No, I was just, it's behind the scenes. I was seeing if I could talk to you guys while that was going on, or if I had to sit in silence which is fine. Listen, I have four kids. I'll take silence.
Compared to the last one, this does not taste like a 9%er at all. They're crushing it on their IPAs. Whole
time. I just fucked up.
Oh, we've been muted this entire time. God, lots of dead air, everybody. Lots of dead air.
Sorry.
But we are...
I can hear you.
That's good. Yeah. Mark can hear us. Yeah. But yeah,
that was a show just for me.
Yes. Protest the Santa again. It's just to reiterate what we just said. It is basically looking back... now it's kind of like we predicted a little bit of something with how shitty this year has been.
Yes.
So if you're listening on the podcast format later, hey, there's about a
I'll cut that down.
Yeah, maybe you will. A minute or so of dead air. Maybe not. Now they're gonna hear another song start to play and then silence. They're gonna be like, "What the fuck just happened?" Yeah. And they're never gonna come back ever again, Justin.
Sorry,
Jesus.
Sorry, Mark.
When you go back to re-listen to yourself talking and us listening to our own music again, you're gonna have to listen to that silence. Don't fast forward. Don't fast forward.
Well, I'll just go by my memory.
Yes.
There you go.
It's a good thing to use if you have a good one. But this is a again the name Space Cake, right?
Space Cake.
It's a double IPA. It's 9%. I think their IPAs are really hitting the spot. The last one not so much. I like this.
For a double
again. I always compare all doubles to Torpedo from Sierra Nevada. That is my favorite double IPA that I've ever had and been able to consistently get over the years. It is what made me realize I like IPAs. But this one's good. I'm slow sipping it, but it is good. And again, doesn't really feel that crazy on the ABV.
No.
Zach, what are you thinking on this one? Scale of 0 to 100. Where are you putting this guy?
62.5.
62.5? All right. Yeah. Okay. Justin, for you?
80.
An 80.
Yeah.
I'm going to go back up a little bit, but yeah, I'm not going to go crazy. I'm going to say a 72. I'm going to say a 72 on this guy.
Okay.
It's a very drinkable beverage. Always a fun thing to say. Always very, very drinkable. And, ooh, we got some new chats going on in there. Who's that?
Merry Christmas, you fuckers. Dennis.
Oh, we got Dennis in the chat. What's up, Dennis? Thanks for joining in, man. Now, Mark, since we're going to be cutting away every so often and then you're just sitting there in silence, I feel it's rude to not talk to you a little bit.
Have you listened to these new songs?
Have you heard any of the new songs over the last couple of weeks?
I don't think I got any Christmas. I'm a couple weeks behind. The last episode I heard was the Walt episode.
The Walt episode. Okay. Oh, very cool. That was a great time. That was a really fun episode.
I'm usually a little more ahead, but I haven't had a chance.
No, it's cool. I'm glad that you're able to hear these new songs then.
And I also want to say good luck to you in the finals in our fantasy league.
I hope you win.
I really hope you win because I just lost to Luke, and then I would have gotten to go head to head with you if I had beaten Luke. I failed to realize that my quarterback wasn't starting, so I got 0 points on one of my quarterbacks, but I still lost by 30 points. So no matter who I picked up with this COVID-infested year, no way was I going to win here. But you need to beat Luke. You need to beat Luke because Luke destroyed us with the two quarterbacks. You need to undo the quarterback rule next year.
Well, if he wins and he's adding it, well, yeah, you can.
I'll give you what.
You when get you, when you get to add a rule?
You get to add or change something. So you can immediately...
I didn't know that.
Yeah, you get to undo. That's what you win.
You could keep it and do something else.
Yeah, you can undo it
and do something else.
But this is what I was going to do. When I was 9-0, you know, when I was 9-0 and then I lost every other game for the rest of the season, every week I lost since I was undefeated... I said,
I think I beat you the
if
first time.
You beat me and then I have not won.
You're welcome.
And now,
and I'm 11th out of 12.
Yeah, you're 11th out of 12. Who's 12?
Me.
Oh, yeah, it's you. I said...
Have you won yet, Zach?
I won one game.
You beat me.
I beat Kyle.
Yeah.
Jets of fantasy.
I have just been... Yeah, there he is, the Jets of fantasy. But the Jets have won every game this year, if you look at the right news articles. But they... I said that if I had the chance and I won, what I was going to do is first undo the quarterback thing. The two quarterbacks suck. But then I was going to make it quarterback, You're going to have a quarterback, a kicker, and your defense, and everything else is going to be all flex positions. So you can just have all wide receivers or all running backs or all tight ends. Yep. However you want to do it, you can mix and match it as much as you want. So I'm going to give you that if you want to use it. I think it's a funny idea, but you should start brainstorming because I'm hoping you pull through. You've been right there at number two until you defeated me and took over the number one spot. So I think it's your year. I'm pulling for the Cameroons. Well,
It's the Camarons, by the way.
Cameroons is how I read it every single time. I'm always like, who's the Cameroons?
It's the Camarons.
Okay.
For Camaron. Sure.
Yeah.
For Aaron.
Yeah.
No,
I got it.
So it would make sense that I would win this league. I'm in two leagues.
Yeah.
And one has money and one doesn't.
Yep.
And I just lost to Matt in the semifinals in the Uncle one with money. Yep, yep.
Oh, man.
Fuck that guy.
So it would make sense that I would win this one because, you know, who needs money?
Nobody needs money.
Nobody needs
money. You don't have a growing family.
We just need a fun time.
Yeah, you need a fun time.
Yeah, no, it's still fun. It's good. No, I can have fun without gambling real money. Sure.
Yeah, sure. That's not a problem in my life at all.
I don't have to buy anything.
I don't need to drink things or gamble to enjoy myself.
No. It's really fun. I didn't realize the rule change thing. Now I'm really.
Yeah, you gotta. If you want me to drop anybody, I'll give you McCaffrey, all right? My number one pick worked out really well this year.
I want him
because he had two really good weeks at the beginning of the year. You know, he did really well. I think he's going to turn around.
Yeah,
I will say the one team besides your team when you were riding high, the one team I've been scared of is Luke's. So
yeah, see how it goes. No, and he's that blue eyed fucking bastard is going to just fucking
listen,
he pierces your soul. I got those
some blue eyes myself, so
yeah, you do.
No, Luke needs to be taken down.
We need a battle of the blue eyes, blue eye battle happening, and then it's the battle of the idiots for third and fourth place between me and Fasano. So it's gonna be a good time.
Bet $1,000.
I'm just glad this time Fasano set his lineup. When I played him earlier, I think I played like three guys.
No, that was good. That's why you had so many points, you know, because nobody else was setting their lineup. That's not because you know what you're doing or anything like that.
Well, I was one of two people in the draft, so.
Yeah, well, that all kind of got fucked up.
That was, I immediately, once I went, oh, I lost, I didn't realize this was playoffs this week, and I went, oh, I lost, sweet, turn off notifications for forever until Zach next September goes, why aren't you starting anybody? And I'm like, we're still playing this game? Okay, cool. Now, we have another beer that we're going to drink. What are we jumping into on this one?
Royal Standard Wee Heavy Ale.
I do like a Wee Heavy style ale. It is always been an enjoyable one for me.
It's down on the ABVs to 8.
All right, we're dropping down to eight here. Right. And while we are sipping on this, we are going to hear, Mark, you're going to love this. We last week did a cover of Feliz Navidad.
I am going
to
love this.
But we did an intergalactical version.
Yes.
So it is, to reiterate for anybody that doesn't know, we took the traditional and we did that a couple of times. And then we switch off and we do Norwegian. We do in different languages. We did a verse and a chorus in Norwegian, which was accompanied with black metal, right? And then we went to Thai. We do a verse and a chorus in Thai, which is like a Thai fusion funk, jazz pop funk thing. And then we went to, I forget the order, I think it's German next. And we went Kraftwerk style on that, like a little classic techno. And you'll enjoy the video if you're watching along. There's a little treat for you in the video part of that. During the Kraftwerk section. And then we jumped over to French and we did French like modern pop. And then we finished it off by making it intergalactic and we did Klingon. So this is... That's the correct response. And we just assumed what Klingon music would sound like in doing so.
So I'm so excited.
This is a 9-minute version of it, but I gotta tell you, for a 9-minute song, it flies by. It's just so ridiculous and silly. Make sure you turn the volume all the way up though towards the end of the Spanish part. You're really gonna need to hear that Norwegian black metal. It's kind of quiet in the background. I think you should turn it up a little bit. So without
I
any
have you
further,
blasting through my truck speakers. So.
Yeah. All right. So you're gonna really love this. So here it is, Feliz Navidad, the intergalactic version from last week. That's from this season. It's our most recent song before today. So hit it. Believe.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Joy on
Do we have? Are we actually? Do we? Are we muted, Justin? Are we unmuted?
No, we're unmuted.
Are you sure?
We're unmuted.
Are you sure? Are you sure this time?
Yes,
are you positive? You're 100%?
Yes.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
100%.
Whatever. Yes. Oh, sorry. Whenever Mark's here, the meanness just like pours over into me. And whenever around Mark, he just makes everybody so much more mean. So
I still feel bad about my Kahlua joke. I'm sorry, Zach.
It's all right, man.
See, you say you're not mean, and then you go and make fun of us fatties over here. Just because you've got the body of a 12-year-old, all right? Just because you're built, you got, a hot...
Wow, Jesus. Did you say a hot 12-year-old?
I was going to say a hot 12-year-old dog is what I was going to say. You got the body of a hot 12-year-old dog? I can't make this any better. It's really... Some 12-year-old dogs would get it. No, I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. Like a Labrador, like a 12-year-old Labrador. There you go.
There you go.
Does she look more like me? Damn it, I'm a hot 12-year-old dog. Fuck. All right. That could be a coffee table. Parties.
I spilled coffee on you.
Yeah, just leave some rings on my back while you're at it. That'll be good. Yes.
Yes.
Really?
Okay.
Oh, no.
We're cutting out.
Oh, we're losing Mark right now.
Did we lose Mark?
Oh, we might have lost Mark. Okay. We lost you there for a second.
We're
back.
Good.
But, okay, yeah, that would make sense. Yeah. They heard you. It's like Beyonce's got the beehive. Integrity's got... Clean. I don't know, the eye chive. I don't know. I was just trying to rhyme. It doesn't work. But yeah, they that would make sense if they sing in Klingon. That would make sense that that's what they're singing like. They should just do a whole Klingon album then. You should pitch that to them. They're obviously listening because they just cut you off. But what we didn't point out last week, and I realized while we were listening, all of the regular vocals, all of the multi-language vocals were done in about 25 minutes.
Right.
And just with me putting Google to my ear and being like, how do they say that in Thailand? Okay, cool. And then just kind of, you know, imitating what it was saying because we went real late. Like, Zach wasn't done with it till like 20 minutes after the hour.
Yeah.
But it was a long one and an epic one. Tim did point out, Tim Holhouse last week pointed out that my French sounded more Spanish. And the more I listened to it, I'm like, yeah, I can't get out of the Spanish voice sometimes once I start doing it. And it's another, you know, it's one of those love languages, you know? And I just throw the Latin flair on everything.
Just mixing them.
That song is going to be a worldwide and an intergalactic success by next Christmas. So get on it now.
Yeah.
So you can tell people.
I think it's my new favorite.
When.
Well, thank you.
It's fun, right? It's fun. And if you notice, during the Kraftwerk section, there are some ravers underneath a bridge somewhere.
Yeah.
What was the... Do we remember? Was that... That was a silent rave one, though. That was... I always thought that was the silent rave, but they're not wearing earbuds, right?
That's I don't remember.
Them... Someone blasting music out of a car and all of them having a rave in the middle of the day under a bridge.
I don't think I've ever seen that video, like, with the original.
It's just
like
goth rave.
Yeah, it's just people just throw it on everything.
Things, yeah.
Yeah.
So we're jumping on that bandwagon a few years too late. But let's get to this beer. The name of this beer again was
this one
was the
it's the 8%. Oh, it's the Wee Heavy Ale.
Royal
Wee Heavy,
Standard.
Yes.
Now
no, it's Wee Heavy.
What does that mean?
A Wee Heavy Ale?
Wee Heavy.
Think that if I'm not
Wee Heavy.
If
it's
I'm
a Wee
not,
Heavy.
If I'm not correct, it's a it basically means it's a little heavy. It's like heavy, but it doesn't taste like it's heavy. I feel like it's Scottish by like origin, but I'm not really sure on that.
It's a woman with the lightning sword riding a lion.
Yeah, that sounds about right. That sounds wee and heavy right there. The lightning
sounds like a van
part. It does. That'd
Mark,
be a great van.
All of these
van.
Clown shoe.
The artwork.
Artwork is all shit that would be on a van.
Yeah.
Any man with a van would be happy to have this.
Yes.
Airbrush on the side.
Anthony Michael Hall and fucking Edward Scissorhands would definitely have these all over his fucking van.
Yep.
I enjoy this. It's 8%. It is not hoppy because it's not, you know, an IPA. It is an ale. It doesn't really give you too much of the maltiness. I think it's a nice, easy drink.
Yeah, no, it's nice.
For a wee heavy, I've had other wee heavies, and it's good. I'm going to go a little bit lower on this one. I'm going to say this is a 64 to me. This is a 64. Yeah. It's still good. It's right below failing if you're in an American class, you know? But it's not terrible.
I'm in the same spot as I was in the last one. It's an 80 for me.
You like it?
Yeah, I enjoy it. I enjoy it.
I feel like a lot of their beer, is like lighter, almost watered, not watered down, but more watery. Like, it's just, again, the phrase I love, it's a very drinkable beverage.
Yes.
Zach, on a 0 to 100 scale, where do you put the wee heavy?
68.
All right, there you go. Now, our next song that we are going to play is the last song before our weekly original for this week, in addition to Zach's single. We're going to be playing you Funkin' Lil' Christmas, which is from last year, and this is our Frank Zappa-inspired song.
I don't remember this one either.
This one and Deep Christmas were the two that when I went back and listened to it, I was like, oh yeah, we did write that song. Yeah. Right. Zach, do you have any recollection of Funkin' Lil' Christmas?
Nope.
All right. So we don't have anything to say about it, but...
I remember it.
We can listen. You remember, remember it? What okay. do you remember do. About this song? Did you remember enjoying it, hating it? What was it?
I remember enjoying it. Did you do this on the episode that Dennis was on?
This might have been, yeah. Like yes. him and was it him and Dom last year?
Yes, yeah, yeah, I feel like yeah. I remember them being on it.
Okay,
yeah.
yeah. Which would make sense that we went artsy because we had the artsy fucks on, you know? We had them artsy guys.
Yeah.
And we needed to really show our street cred to them.
Yeah.
So yeah, this Funkin' Lil' Christmas. It's just a weird again, Frank Zappa inspired single.
What a beer you got there though.
Yeah, what's the, oh thank you. Thank you for catching
that. The Bubble Farm IPA 6.5%.
Bubble Farm also sounds like a Frank Zappa album. Yes. Like next to Bubble Farm.
Yeah.
All right. So
with Space Cake.
Space Cake. Yeah, they could all be. Yeah. We're going to jump into this single. We're going to get that beer passed around and we're going to sip on it. This is another shorter one, not a crazy long one. It's like under 5 minutes, right?
4:17.
4:17. That's under 5 minutes. All right, guys. So here you go. Here is Funkin' Lil' Christmas off of Christmas 2 from 2019. Enjoy.
It's about that time for the cheer and wine. Your hair for some gravy. Wrapped up in parkas and scarves, the tree will help out the dark. Ready the fire, hang stockings if desired. We'll be right back.
right, so there you have it. That's fucking little Christmas. Mark, you're playing around with backgrounds there. Was that you in your truck in front of your truck? Was that what that just was?
Yeah.
That was great. That was great.
I was trying to pretend like it was like I was getting run over by the plow.
Yeah, I can see that. After you got ran over by that snowman that I thought was just the background from Hoth or something like that.
No, that's the snowman we built.
Nice.
It's like 9 feet tall. Jeez. I had to use a ramp to build it.
Oh, fuck yeah. That's was it. When you say we, how much of it was you, and then how much of it was the kids just going, do that?
No. So the boys all made giant snowballs while I was plowing.
Okay.
And then we finished them up when I was done the next day. And then I had them like stand behind the snowball while I rolled the other big ones up a ramp. So they actually helped a lot.
Oh, hell yeah. I remember
my kids
making...
are pretty strong. I gotta say.
I remember making big snowmen as a child and just finding the next, like, the closest adult and just being like, hey, I need you for the top parts of this because that ain't, but 9 feet, never went 9 feet. I think I might have done, like, a 6 foot tall one at one point, but never a 9 footer.
It drives Beth crazy. She's like, how come you have to build the most giant snowmen and every single snowball is the same size? They're supposed to get smaller.
Nope.
Whatever. But it's a snowman.
But each kid wants to make a giant snowball, so what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, don't body shame snowmen, Beth. Yeah. Jeez.
God. Yeah, really?
There could be...
Of course, he's dead now.
He is dead?
He leaned and fell over about 2 days
later. It always happens. Although this last week, it was probably the best time to let one live for a while because it stayed cold. That shit stayed
on the
ground.
Can I just say, when I watched Frosty the Snowman, for the longest time, I never got why he would say happy birthday.
Oh, yeah. He just
it's the
said,
first thing. Yeah,
happy birthday.
It's
what? Because it's his birthday.
Yeah, exactly.
He's a sociopath.
He was just born.
Happy birthday.
Yeah. Happy birthday. Ooh. All right, so again,
I've seen that movie so many times.
That was our Zappa-inspired single from last year, and we are drinking this one, right? The Bubble Farm. Now, this is the lowest ABV out of the ones we've had so far. It is the most hoppy on the initial taste, I think, than any of the other ones. And so for me,
it's still smooth though.
It is smooth. It goes away after that first sip, but for me, it's just kind of like it could be a white can with a black label that just says IPA on it.
Yes.
It is not bad by any means, but I am probably, besides the one that I hated, that pecan pie, this is the one I'm the least impressed with so far.
That's why I'm sort of scared for the porter.
Yeah, and where we're going next after this. So I'll just give this right off the bat. I'm gonna give it a 60. It's all right.
It's going 65.
65? Zach, what are you thinking on this one? 0 to 100?
59.
All right. Now, you're getting our next selection ready. What is the next one going to be?
Chocolate sombrero.
Oh, this one, I think, name-wise,
chocolate
is the one that I am the most excited about. And that's great because it comes with the song I am most excited about. We are now going to be playing our Brunch Weekly original single for this week, which, again, if I didn't say before, it's called Christmas Without You. I lyrically wrote this song basically just about being like, hey, like you're split with your girl type of thing, and you're just gonna have a nice, easy breezy, you know, no problems Christmas, and you're just like, you're ditching somebody that you should have ditched a long time ago.
Right.
And lyrically, it's kind of from the standpoint of an asshole who's just like, fuck you, bye. But musically, Zach, where were we starting at on this one, and where do you think we ended up?
We started with AC/DC.
Yeah, and we started with drums.
Yes.
Because we were going AC/DC, you said just lay down the drum beat, and I'll write to the drum beat.
Right.
So, Justin, you jumped in there and you laid down the drums. Yes. We played a little bit of AC/DC to kind of get us in the mood.
Yeah.
And then you just kind of went from there. How hard is it for you not knowing, not having anything to play to, just thinking, okay, play like AC/DC? Is that more of a challenge when there's nothing there, or do you kind of feel the freedom of, I can do whatever?
I mean, there is some freedom and then there's some restriction, and there's a trickiness to it because, you know, you'll say it a lot, like, don't play ghost notes, because I'll tend to just try and get extra shit in there. And it's like, no, it just needs to be a driving thing. So it's like, okay, stay within that parameter. But then when you're writing from scratch with nothing behind it, like, literally just a click, it has its own setbacks.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, definitely. It's only, you can only be as creative as what you, whatever you come up with in that set. So
now Jeff is in the chat saying that he is the resident AC/DC fan, and that is true. We've referenced him being an AC/DC fan in the past. He was the one that showed me their newest album.
Out sounding like AC/DC.
Not at all. Music. Yeah. If you strip the lyrics, if you strip the vocals off of it,
the drum beat and the guitar track.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. But we sort of
we
went
brunched
some
it
other
up.
Ways.
We brunched it up quite a bit. What time did we wind up on this one? Under 4 minutes.
3:41.
So this is a nice little short one. But since we started early today, Zach was home at like 2:30, something like that. And he wrote the one song. So we got started on this around about like 3:30, 4 o'clock maybe.
Like that.
And we were on to vocals by 6. So that is usually when we start writing. So we had a lot more time to focus on vocals. And being able to do that, we decided, Zach, you were saying we're just going to kind of overlayer the fuck out of this. We're just going to have layer upon layer of vocals, really make it sound full. Sometimes we don't have time to do more than one or two takes on something.
Yeah.
So it sounds a little empty, lacking of something, a little bit more like a demo, which is just the gift and the curse of this dumb game we've invented for ourselves here, making these Brunch Weekly original singles. But I think this has the potential of being one of the best songs we've ever written. Again, we've not listened to it all the way through, even though we have listened to all of it multiple times, but not all straight through.
Right.
Again, lyrically, it's about just, you know, it's Christmas without you, but in a good way. Anything else either of you want to add to this song before into it?
I'm happy with how it came out. I think it's the most polished thing that we've done.
Yep. And maybe like we're learning.
Where are you, like, within the last, in this past season, where we've gotten as far as with you getting your compressions and how you want to master everything has come out way better.
Things are just always getting better. It's the game.
Things are always getting better. But, so let's just jump right into it. Here it is, again, our 7th song of the evening, Christmas Without You, our Brunch Weekly original single for this week. Enjoy, and we'll see you guys back in about 4 minutes. All right, guys, there you have it. Again, that is Christmas Without You, our Brunch Weekly original single for this week and our final Christmas song of this year.
Yes.
So,
that was awesome.
Thank you. Thank you very much for listening and enjoying it.
Yeah.
I did enjoy it. It was really good.
Thank you.
Now, the fun thing with that, again, we said we started with AC/DC, and then Zach was just like, or it kind of also sounds like Bad Company, and you threw on Bad Company. I was like, yeah. And then you were like, that's more in your range and more what I generally can sing. So, and we just kind of went down the path, and we turned it into a pop song at the end of it. So, basically, it makes me realize that if you just start with AC/DC, which just means start simple, you know, just it's the keep.
Well,
it
in
simple,
modern
stupid.
Times, they are a pop band.
Yeah, yeah.
Unfortunately,
we got a thumbs up from Jeff,
way.
So that's a good thing. Thumbs up from Jeff there. But vocally, yeah, I kind of was leaning more into my attempt of the version of like a David Lee Roth like style. You know, like the echo to the chorus and everything like that. Right. I always like it when a chorus is driven by the backing vocals, and then the lead singer just kind of jumps in and does a little in the background.
Right.
You know, that's
right.
It's something I've always enjoyed because you just kind of go, yeah, the lead singer kind of fuck off, and the best part of the song is still happening. Like, right. The lead singer could fall into the crowd and lose his microphone, and the best part of the song is still rocking and rolling there.
Right.
But yeah, that's Driving. That is one of our shorter, if not around our shortest. I think Protest of the Santa is our shortest Christmas song.
I believe so.
But yeah, that's just it's just fun, and I'm going to be bumping that all week. I'm going to be bumping that into a fucking March. Who am I kidding? And yeah. Again, next year, it's going to be... It's a fun
thank
pop
you.
Song.
Thank
we could
you,
change
you.
The lyrics to be about something not Christmas related, and it would just be a pop song. But where would we be then? We'd be one less amazing Christmas song in this world.
You know, I did come to a realization listening to All American.
Yeah.
That we need to sell that chorus to like college football.
Oh
network.
Yeah. Being All American. Yeah. We could definitely sell a lot of our music to somebody with money if they just gave us the money.
Give us the money.
Just give us the money, assholes. All right. Now we.
You want to buy it, Mark?
$10. You can have all of it. You can have all of it. $10 for all of it. Now we are drinking.
$10.25. I want the 25 cents.
Fuck! He's gonna sell to them for 20. We're gonna be God fucked out of that $10 extra. We could have each had $3.33. Damn it!
I'm out of the bench.
I'm done. Zach gets $3.34. He gets the odd, you know, the extra penny for doing a lot of the heavy lifting there.
Exactly.
But only a penny more. Now we are drinking this Mexican style. What was it again?
I had to chug it.
Yeah, I don't really like it. What was the name and the style of this one again?
It was. I'm sorry, it's in front of me. Yes. It is chocolate sombrero.
Yeah. Definitely getting a little bit of the chocolate. I think the sombrero part is where we're falling off. It has like the pecan pie. There's kind of a chemical taste.
Whatever
to it.
They're doing with their darks is
whatever.
Right.
It's not nearly as good as what they do
it's
with their
so
IPAs.
Thin too in the mouth.
Yeah. You were hoping that it would be thicker in the mouth. You know, you really wanted a thicker mouth feel there.
I feel
whenever
like
you're putting something
the same
in your
way.
Mouth, you want thickness.
I don't know if you brew.
I get down with the thickness, guys. I get down with the thickness.
I don't know if you brew a stout or porter differently than you do anything else,
I'm
but I feel
so.
Like
that's how it's probably
I feel like
different.
They follow that same approach as their IPAs.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, it doesn't. There needs to be more of a mouthfeel on this for it to really sell it.
Yeah.
And yeah, there's just something kind of about it.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's definitely not worse than the pecan, so I don't go that low. But I'm gonna give this a 47. It's just kind of it's definitely below middle of the road for me, but
it's a 48
I'm not gonna I'm not gonna yell at you if you hand this to me, you know. I'm not gonna yell at you for that.
Yeah, I'll drink it.
Zach, what are you giving this guy?
I was thinking about a 40.
A 40? Yeah. All right, yeah. Fair enough. Now we're gonna be jumping now into our we're going from our shortest to our longest single. Now this is the first of any cover we've ever done. But the second cover you're hearing tonight, we did the Feliz Navidad already, but we are now going to play our version of We Three Kings. And our version of We Three Kings, the story that I told last year when we premiered it, is that Zach looked up, like, Arlo Guthrie or somebody's fucking version, I forget who it was, but you looked up somebody's version of this song.
Oh, yeah, it was some...
Old, not Hank, but it was like, you know.
Yeah, it was like an old country.
Old country guy, and you looked it up, and you played it, and you went, okay, cool. And we're sitting there, and I'm like, oh, I have to do nothing for this. All I have to do is sing We Three Kings. And then I get up to the mic and I'm like, why is this in the weirdest key? And then you look at the chords, you looked up, and you went, oh, I guess I was supposed to put the capo on 2 on this, but I didn't do that, so fuck it. I went, so now we're just in a totally different key, and now I have to relearn in what I thought was going to be a 5-minute easy cinch job, just done. We had no time, and I had to like figure out how to sing it, and this was like painful for me.
Yeah, I remember you being super frustrated.
But now, listening back to it, I prefer this way is the way it came out. Sometimes accidents happen, and they just make better things out of those accidents. Mm-hmm. I'm one of those things. And I think this is one of my favorite Christmas songs ever. When I go to church on Christmas Eve, which is generally the only time I'll go to church, and this year, not having to do that. Thank you, COVID. You made me have to skip Thanksgiving, and you made me have to skip Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
That does mean Zach doesn't get to play dickhead at church with his family this year.
Yeah.
That's true. That's kind of upsetting.
Are you guys going to get together and just do it?
Just play dickhead with your mom? Just go to the church empty and just start shouting dickhead in the church. And then
I don't
leave.
Know if they're having church.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Earlier, our buddy Fasano came over, and he was showing us a video from a terrible car crash that his brother was in, and he's fine. His friend is not as great, but they're alive. And he showed us the video, but before he showed us the video, he said, my dickhead brother ran over a cliff with his friend in a car. And the way he said it, and he kept saying it, he goes, my dick had a brother. And I'm like, your dick had a brother? I'm like, your dick had a brother? I'm like, what? He goes, my dick had a brother and just ran over the fucking cliff. And I'm like, your dick had a brother and it ran over a cliff. I have no idea what this conversation is, man. Like, this is fucking bizarre to me. And for whatever reason, I just had to bring that up. Yeah. But either way, We Three Kings. We Three Kings,
what's
I love
the
this
next
song.
Beer as well?
It's an amazing song. And what is the next beer?
It is a great song.
Eagle Claw Fist.
Mm.
8% IPA.
All right. Now, I'm going to not even bother sipping this one. You can do whatever you're going to do. I'm not going to bother sipping this one until the last minute of the song, so I have a little bit to talk about when we get to the end. But again, we did this really epic, loud, in-your-face version of We Three Kings. This is the version that you should be singing at church, so tell your pastor, your minister, your priest, I guess not a rabbi. He wouldn't be doing that. But
Tell your rabbi.
Jesus is the reason for the seasons, bro. And he'll just go, I didn't like the second part. I just stick with the original. Because that's basically when you boil it down. Judaism. I knew a guy that was a born-again Jew, as he called himself. He was born and raised Hasidic Jewish, and then he found Jesus. He said, he tried to relate to us kids back in the day. He goes, The Jewish people like the first book, but they don't like the second book. Yeah. So basically, they're purists to the original, and I just really like the sequel. And I was like, oh, so you basically just told me it really doesn't matter, is basically what you just said. It's just it's liking, you know, one movie over its sequel. It's just like, was Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 1 better than Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2? Maybe.
Right.
But that's basically the argument.
So does that mean that... Does that mean that pagans are like the prequels?
Yes, they're the prequels, which is why people hate them, because they're coarse and they get into everything. Like sand.
Too much galactic politics.
And midichlorians, come on. What? You should have just said M count from the beginning and we would have been all right with M count.
Speaking of which,
better way to do it.
Did you watch The Mandalorian?
We can't get into spoilers because upstairs.
I did.
Okay. Okay. No spoilers. No spoilers. Because
let's just do a collective. Oh my god!
But how good?
It was good.
Did you watch the post credits?
Yeah, I watched everything.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, all right. He's good, back, so good. We can't keep talking about it. Awesome. So either way, let's jump into it. We're going to be sipping...
He didn't watch it yet?
I don't think he's watched any of this season yet.
I haven't watched any of this season yet.
We've just been tiptoeing around it for fucking 3 months.
Why?
Because he's
jerk. Dude, because I am busy with other stuff.
Work.
Cyberpunk is a big...
I work every day.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
He finds
a way to father 4 children, have a wife, run a household with her.
Cyberpunking. So.
And
he isn't playing
Cyberpunk. You're not
cyberpunk.
Playing Cyberpunk. Cyberpunk takes up just as much energy as running a family and having a life.
It does.
And also, I'm up really late every night with a baby, so...
Fair enough.
That's yeah, dude, I'm, like, literally asleep by 9 every night.
Do you ever hold your baby and look at your baby and just refer to it as the child while you're watching Mandalorian? Because you should start
doing
that.
Yeah, I got one
it.
Of those, like, weird egg things that float around.
Hell yeah.
Oh, change your name to Grogu.
How much would that... He doesn't even know that. How much would...
I know that. I'm not an idiot. I have the internet, Kyle.
Oh, I just figured you were avoiding it because you don't want things to be spoiled like what happened in the last episode. But either way, let's jump into We Three Kings. Again, a nice 10-minute and something version of this single. So if you got to pee, now's the time to do it.
Jeez.
Back.
I got to go to bed.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, guys, there you have it.
Thanks, that Mikey.
Thank you, Mikey in the chat. That's our version of We Three Kings. Mikey in the chat is saying that he's getting some heavy Mars Volta Christmas vibes, and he'll allow it.
Yes,
he'll allow it. As we were saying, you guys were saying while we were listening, that is something that the two of you could just do for hours and hours and hours. That is really right up your alley. That is 100% you guys. And again, the vocals, that is one of the only times, I think maybe the only time we've had to use auto-tune to correct something, because I just could not hit the high, the feeling fountain, just because it was just in a different key.
I like the stylized vocals on it, though.
It works out.
I really do.
It does work out. Now, we do have to talk about and rate this beer. What was the name of this one again? This is our...
you have it.
Is this... Oh, the Eagle Claw Fist. IPA. It's good. It's... I think it's a little bit more hoppy on the taste than the last 6.5%. This one is back to the 8%ers. I'm going to have to give this... I'll give it a 64. It's, again, just kind of... It's above middle of the road. It is almost a full passing grade, but it is just kind of an IPA. I'm not really, like, shocked or surprised by it in any way.
Yeah, it's okay.
What are you thinking, Justin? What's your grade on this guy?
I'm going to give it a 67.
67. And, Zach, what are you thinking on
this
one?
It's okay.
Yeah.
61.394156.
I am going to add all those numbers up, you asshole. I do like the color of it, though. I will say that you don't see many IPAs that are this dark.
Yeah.
So I like that approach to it. But, yeah, kind of just... I think we're going to be ramping up for the last couple of ones, though, with what we have coming up.
Yes.
Now, we have been...
No, go ahead. I was just going to say, before you start getting into the Nog thing, I just want to say the next... Out of the next four songs, it contains my three favorite Christmas songs.
Okay.
And the next one is my third favorite.
Your third favorite. All right. I have to look at the list to remember what I put on it in what order.
Well, it is A Christmas Carol.
Oh, yeah. Christmas Carol's a fun one.
Then Deep Christmas.
Yep.
Then Parallel Christmas.
And then Satan Baby is what we're going to be closing with, the Christmas Carol is
perfect closer.
Yeah, yes. Christmas Carol is our attempt at doing like a rap rock mashup of like the 90s,
the Beastie Boys,
like 80s, 90s, Beastie Boys, Run DMC. So that one's going to be our next song that we jump into. But we've been joined and we've been lucky to have him in any capacity. We always love to have Mark here.
I don't know if I translate in Zoom too well.
But. Hey man, not many people do. It's kind of difficult, but you are Bill Hatering the fuck out of those backgrounds.
Yes.
Is that what you were agreeing with me? That's what you think of as well?
Yes.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall, him just going, "Oh, I'm on the moon."
I love Bill Hader.
He's amazing. Yeah. But the woman that played his wife in that is like has one of the best faces like to work with him like
she does.
His face is just so expressive, and to be standing next to him and being the person who has the best face in the scene is like you're kind of just you win there.
Right.
But we, again, it's our tradition to have you on here for Christmas. We all love you. We all miss you, and we are happy that you were able to be here.
I miss you guys.
I missed
the whole season.
I know you did. It's the first. Well, season four was the first time any season happened where you were not involved in it in any way. That is the only season that you did not make a guest appearance. You've made up for it on other seasons. You did that episode with Mikey. Doubled down like here and there, but you definitely.
I saw it coming.
You knew it was gonna happen, so you went. You know what? Game of Thrones and Endgame are happening right now. I should go on because next year it will be the end of games.
Yeah,
we won't be able to
have fun no more. But usually when you're on the show, we drink Nog. We drink Nog out of our Christmas vacation.
We can't even get them right now.
Wally World
it's all packed away.
Cups, but they're all packed away because the kitchen's being remodeled, so we couldn't get to them. So you're not drinking out of them. We're not drinking out of them. We'll just say it's out of solidarity. You have fun, eggnog. but we just have regular
and
eggnog.
I drank too much of it.
Well, I just want to say, and if you guys want to add anything to this, Merry Christmas to you, Mark. Love you, your family. Miss you. Soon,
I love
someday,
you guys. I miss you.
We'll be able to be. We'll do a Christmas in July once all this ends next year, and we'll just have you on, and we'll drink nog. We'll find someone,
and we'll dig that beer up from the backyard.
Yeah, we didn't dig the beer up from a year ago. That were you here when we buried the beer in the backyard last year?
I was not.
We buried a beer after a show.
There is still a video of that,
and
by the
there's
way.
A video of me following Zach out and Zach burying a beer about an inch and a half underground. So it probably did not hold very well.
No.
And it's next to the roots of a tree. But right now it's covered in a bunch of snow, and we'd have to really dig to figure it out. But we love you, brother. We miss you. And we don't drink nog without you. We just don't do it. Nah. If you guys want to add anything else to that, Mark.
Oh, man. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Mark, if you would like to, you know the words that you have to say, right?
Well, first off, let me just say, as soon as possible, I'm going to get vaccinated just so I can come on the show.
Hell yeah, dude.
Wonderful.
Hell yeah.
And drink your nog!
Drink your nog! It's not nearly as good without booze, but it's still nog.
Good. I still love it.
It's still good with rum, I gotta say.
Oh, yeah.
That is amazing. All right, well, brother, we're gonna let you go. We know you got a busy life.
My shift starts, so...
Yeah, your shift does start. All right, brother. Well, we love you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being here, dude.
Say thank you to Beth for letting you have a little bit of time with us, and we'll see you again soon, man. Merry Christmas to you, dude.
Merry Christmas, guys. Love you.
Love you too, dude.
Bye.
Bye. All right, guys. Again, that is the meanest man in the world
you're ever
going to meet.
He's still here.
Mark
he
Miller.
Hasn't
he's
actually
mean.
Left.
He hasn't left yet. He's trying
to
now.
I want to eavesdrop and listen to you talk about me.
He's gonna figure it out. You can do that on YouTube. Give us a fucking view count, man.
What the fuck?
Now, okay, that was the last song we did was our cover of We Three Kings, and our next one from a couple of weeks ago is our retelling of A Christmas Carol.
Yes.
And again, we do it in kind of the Run DMC vibe. So
it's my third favorite Christmas song.
It's really good. It's really good. So let's jump into that.
No, we got one.
We got to talk about beer. I was so focused on the nog. Did we grade this one? We graded this one, right?
Yes, we graded
this one. This is a hard beer fucking day together. We're running the
quadruple.
Mark, thanks for being
one here, man dude. Holiday, the Belgian quad.
Oh, one man holiday. It kind of goes in theme with our
one
song.
One man show.
Yeah, and one man show. One man holiday. He's on a holiday right now. But yeah, so let's jump into, we're going to start passing this around, and let's just jump right into Christmas Carol. We're already at 11 o'clock, and we've got, you know, four more songs to do, and one of them is a 10-minute song. Yeah. So let's jump right into it. Here is A Christmas Carol. Enjoy.
Wanted to see his grumpy face at mass. wants to be on a set Ebenezer Street. Change your tune or you'll see soon your name carved up on this grave. When Scrooge awoke, he was a different bloke. He changed for good within. He bought up a goose, went to Bob's to cut loose, bringing Christmas with him.
There you guys have it again. That is A Christmas Carol, our Brunch Weekly original single from about 2-3 weeks ago. Yes. What were you just saying? You added backup vocals to it after we had finished doing the main vocals. And when we watched it live and listened to it live, I had no idea that you had added vocals. And then when I went back and listened to it on the surround sound at home, I was just like, oh shit, there's Zach. Didn't realize that. But it is weird how, like, I don't know if it's just like after years of doing this, that you know my tonality, so you have like the ability to kind of like sing in that same tonality, or if we've just kind of morphed into more of the same person vocally on that. You always will have the higher register.
Yeah, we just have a pretty big overlap of the bottom of what I got is the top of what you got.
Yeah.
And I feel like I can match you on the low sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. So basically what we're finding out is that I'm a middle, and Justin's a power bottom, and Zach's a power top. And that's basically where we're going with here. But yeah, that was... I love that song. That song, I was very,
it's my
very,
third favorite Christmas song.
I was very unsure of it after we finished it, just kind of going like, I don't know how that's going to all like translate at the end.
Well, it's funny because when you really first talked about that the next week, you're like, Ricky said this is his favorite song.
Yeah, Ricky was like, my buddy Ricky at work was just like, I love that. He goes, you did the little, like, he goes, I don't know what you would call it musically, just like the echo part. I went, oh, as Zach put it, I LL Cool J'd the fuck out of it. Just like, LL Cool J it. You know, just do that little echo, the little jump in, where it's like not the same amount of words every time. It's just what kind of felt right in the moment.
Yeah. Right.
But it's fun, it's flowy, and it fucking works. Now, our next beer that we have to rate is the one that we're sipping on now, is the Quad.
The Quad.
This, again, is, all these are from Clown Shoes. It is the One Man Holiday Belgian Style. Again, a Belgian style, because they can't say Belgian. Style quadruple ale.
It's a moldy flavor to me, or taste to it.
It's a what?
It has like a moldy.
Moldy.
Like a old flavor.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like, yeah.
Like a musty.
Yeah, there's a little, like, a little bit of muskiness to it. I love triples and quads. I love Belgian style beer. So as I was saying while we were listening to that, this is the one I'm going to grade the harshest. Now, for a quad, it is only 8%. Usually you get a quad, you're thinking it's going to be 12, 11, right. 10 at the minimum.
Right.
So I will say it gets watery. A lot of these seem to, like, the flavors hit right up front, and then they kind of, like, back off, which makes them, again, very drinkable. But it doesn't, there's no sustainability on the flavor on this one. So I feel like I'm, I like it more than two others.
I would not buy this
one. I would not. I would not go out and purchase this one again, because especially with the word quad written right on there, it's going to be $16 for a four-pack type of deal if you found this in bottles or in big cans.
Serve it with blue cheese and crackers.
I'm kind of, yes. That would make this situation a lot better.
Yes.
I need some blue cheese in my life at all times. And we got enough crackers here. Three to be exact. I am kind of disappointed on this one. I am going to give it a 56.
I'm going 55.
55? Is that what you're thinking right about there? Zach, what are you thinking on this
60.
One? 60. 60?
All right.
Yeah, it's...
It's okay.
Quad, you just expect a lot more from a quad. You really, really do. And what you might expect from this next song is the exact opposite of what the original single for this week was. This week was about just, you know, ditching your bitch and just going, bro.
Ditch
you know, just
bitch.
Like, ditch your bitch and go. This one is about you fucked up and you were trying to get her back. And you're in deep trouble.
Deep Christmas.
And
yeah,
that is
I
why the song is called Deep Christmas.
I don't remember the music.
Yeah.
But I remember, when you were talking about that, I remember recording this.
Yeah. I really liked writing this one. I was like, we need to write more of a somber Christmas song. And I think we pulled it off here. Before we get to playing that, what is our third to last beer, I'm assuming? Yeah, third to last beer.
Yeah.
Okay, this is called Advent Party Crasher.
Mm.
And it is a commando in a Santa hat stabbing the wolfman in the throat.
Nice.
There's
very
a little,
traditional Christmas.
Dobby-looking elf.
All right.
If you're a Harry Potter fan. And Frankenstein and the leprechaun. And the girl from The Grudge.
Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a pretty fucking wild...
Can. Yeah, yeah. And what is the style of the beer?
American Imperial Stout.
Okay.
And did they break 10% on this one?
No.
It's 8. Yeah. See, that's right. I'm feeling like they're going for the style, but they're not going with the alcohol content.
I'm hoping that this one doesn't have that weird
Yeah,
flavor.
If so, we just know not to get Clown Shoes dark beer. Just don't buy anything dark from Clown Shoes.
Right.
But either way, let's jump into our third to last song of the evening, Deep Christmas. From Christmas 2, last year in 2019. Hit it up.
But she found me a liar. some cookies. I'd mix her favorite drink. I'd do anything to have her. Could you help me save Nick? I'll get her a diamond. I'll buy her that ring. I'll pay any price for my meaningless fling. I don't need no presents, just a way to take it back. Mistakes I have made, if you're real, at least do that.
There you have it. If you're in deep this Christmas, that is the song for you. Just let Santa know that you just want her near. You just want her near. And near rhymes with beer. Transitions. Advent Party Crasher.
Yes.
American Imperial Stout.
It's way better than the other two dark
not ones. Not that weird chemical taste in here.
It's thicker.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I am more on board with this. But still, I feel like the it still could be thicker. I feel like this would be great as a nitro. Like, if this was a nitro and, like, it was a heavy pour, that would knock it out of this world.
For
an Imperial Stout, like, it's not really... It doesn't really hit me the way an Imperial Stout, I feel like, should hit me. But for an American Imperial Stout, which means that you took something and ripped it off in a shitty way, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm still kind of in the 50. I'm gonna give it a 58. That's what's kind of popping in my head. I'm not loving it, but I like it. I like it.
Yeah.
What are you thinking, Justin?
65.
65.
Yeah.
I was thinking 64.
64. Yeah. All right. So it's not bad. Another one that I probably wouldn't go out and buy again. Mm. There are much better Imperial Stouts that you can go with, and there are Imperial Stouts that incorporate other flavors other than just a traditional Imperial Stout. I feel like if you're going that realm, you really have to kick it up in the high octane. And this is, again, only an 8%er here. But, I mean, we're learning that their IPAs are good.
Yes.
And everything else is just kind of a question mark.
Yes.
So that was Deep Christmas. We're going to be jumping into Parallel Christmas.
It's my second favorite Christmas song.
It's really fun. And it is our second or third longest Christmas song that we've ever done, and the first one that we did this year.
Yes.
I know we're all still kind of slow sipping on this, so we don't have to pop it open yet, but what is our second to last beer that we're going to be drinking?
Is the Happy Feet Black IPA.
I am really stoked about this
one. I am too.
What is a black IPA?
It's just a darker IPA. It's like the properties of a stout, but it's got the hoppiness to it.
Yeah,
I thought
it was a blend of the two, sort of.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Like, you take hops or the way you would blend it, or the way you would brew a stout with the IPA.
Yeah.
Which might be their best beer, because it seems like they're brewing their stouts as their IPA.
That's where I'm hoping now, after having all of their darks and everything like that, that this might really kind of pull through for us. What was the name of it, though, again? It's the
Happy Feet.
Hoppy Feet. All right. Well, guys, we're going to be finishing the Advent and jumping over to the Hoppy Feet while you listen to our Genesis/Yes/Asia/Rush inspired Christmas single, Parallel Christmas. Again, this is written about the idea that a guy is just zonked out of his brain, sitting around wondering, does Christmas exist in other planes of existence? And we incorporate some fun noises and sounds in this one. This is the one that's got the farts in it.
No,
right?
That's all American. That's from the...
That's from Americana. That's from Last Americana. Yes. What do we do with... Oh, no, this is the one where I just do weird... I just have like a dialogue, like a monologue to myself in there. Yeah. Right. This is the weird one on that, right? Yeah. All right, so here you guys go. Again, our second longest and our second to last single of the evening. Here is Parallel Christmas. Enjoy.
Gathering like you and me, is there another place where it- it holly and jolly and skating on ice? Do they share stories, drink into the night? Are there cheers of love warming up each room? Are they leaving out cookies, hoping Santa will be soon? Is there log on the fire, crackling all aglow? Are they hanging up stockings? I wonder if they know. Christmas time is near here. I wonder if it's Christmas there. I wonder if it's Christmas there.
Christmas is here. Christmas, Christmas, 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 Christmas is near. I wonder if Christmas exists in every plane of existence. Christmas, Christmas, Christmas is here. Christmas, Christmas, Christmas is near. I wonder if Christmas exists in every plane of existence.
That is Parallel Christmas. We were lamenting while we were listening to it. That was just a really fun, silly, stupid song to write.
Yeah.
A lot of fun, catchy hook parts. The bridge is, again, one of those that's just... When the bridge part hits, it's like, oh, that could have just been its own song on its own, and that would have been good. But altogether, it works so well. I thoroughly
enjoy it.
That's
my second favorite Christmas song that we've done. And it's very much so up there in all of the songs that
we've
done.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Thank you, thank you. Yeah,
and
now...
If everybody that just joined us, please stick around. The next song is my favorite song that we've done for Christmas.
I think it's my favorite vocal performance on any Christmas song. And
I just love the concept.
The concept of it, everything, loving the bongos. All right. He likes, likes the bongos. I don't want to put loving it. in his mouth. You know, he likes it. He said he likes it.
I'll put some loving in your mouth.
Jeff, I got your Christmas date for you right here. Now,
sorry, Jeff.
He was faking. Before we get to our final song, Satan Baby.
Yeah.
Let's talk about this Satan Baby of a fucking beer we're drinking. This is bullshit. This is a bad beverage.
Yeah.
This should have been so much better. Their IPA, Zach, you said it best. Their first three beers were really good.
Yes.
And then it just dropped after that. They're hoping you're drunk by the third day of Christmas and you're not paying attention after that. It's kind of what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
They're putting the clown shoes on us, making us look like a bunch of dummies, guys. I thought that the bad side of the dark beers that they were making was going to mix, like you said, Justin, with the IPAs, and they were going to do it well. This one, you
it's
said
not
soapy.
The worst beer,
you said soapy. I can see soapy.
Fragrant. Like, I don't know.
I have almost a lack of all things in this beer. It should have more flavor in general. Should have more. There should be more girth in every meaning of the word girth. There should be more girth in this, and there is not. I'm not gonna give it. I don't remember now what I gave. I think I gave the worst one a 35. I'm gonna give this a 42.
Okay.
It's just eh. I would honestly, I almost poured it out into my eggnog cup, thinking, actually, I'm going to do that. If I pour it into the eggnog cup with the remnants of eggnog that I just spilt on myself, will it make it any better? I think it might. So I just poured it into there. It makes it really gross looking. You know, it still sucks. It's the nog disappeared completely.
Yeah.
It's not good. So that's where I'm sitting at. Justin, what are you thinking on this
41.
One? 41. Yeah. And Zachary?
12.
12.
Oh,
yeah.
All right.
It's just not good. It's just not a good beer. Sorry, clown shoes. You're the fool this time. Now we have one last beer, and now our
Hopefully
Christmas.
Hopefully, it's the best one.
I hope. I really hope it's Galactical.
Galactica. I assume Galactica. This is going to be Galaxy hops.
Yeah, yes, that's probably. What I'm assuming. It's Galaxy hops. It's the least Christmas themed one of all of them,
and it's the 12th day that they've listed.
And it's the 12th day. They should have just called it like Life Day or something like that, because you know, give it an intergalactic Christmas meaning. You know, Life Day would have worked here. Yeah. And I don't think Disney's going to sue you over Life Day, right? Oh, actually, the Lego Christmas movie, they're probably gonna sue you. Now, Lucy is about to have fun in this box.
Yes,
she's enjoying it, and I'm kicking at her, and now she wants to attack my feet. Right. What is the ABV? And this one's
8.
And this is a traditional IPA.
Double
IPA. Okay, yeah, so it's probably Galaxy Hops.
I think the double IPA was one of the first three, the first ones that we were drinking.
Now, we just had the Fog to compare this to.
Yes. And
if it is so much
Galaxy. No, this is very golden. Looks promising.
Ooh, that looks nice. That looks nice. Now, our final song of the evening.
Do you remember? You remember what the song
Yeah, so Satan Baby was the idea behind the song is that a child wrote a letter to Santa, but they had a misspelling and they wrote it to Satan, and a mailman actually delivered it to Satan. And then Satan decides to show up and fulfill Santa duties, basically.
Yes.
So basically we made a Krampus song, just not about Krampus.
Right.
Now, I remember recording this and going, we were going for Peter Steele style vocals. It was that typo negative feel for a Christmas song. And I remember smoking like 4 cigarettes back to back to back to back and taking a couple of swigs of, I think we had Rebel Yell, if I'm not mistaken. I think it was something like that at that point.
Probably.
That was during the Rebel Yell years. Before we became adults and Zach just started buying Jim Beam like a normal human being. And we were trying the new cool hip Rebel Yell. We had some real rough nights on Rebel Yell.
Yeah.
And Old Granddad.
And Old Granddad. Yes. Oh, and if we're hanging out with Steve-O, Old Crow. And Old Granddad. Anything old, Steve-O's there for. I will say I think this might be my favorite Christmas song as well. It's up there with what we've done. I always really, like everything that we played tonight, but this one is one that I'm like, if I'm showing people our music And I go, do you want to just hear something really weird just to kind of like give you an idea? This is it. Storyline-wise, yeah. Musically, everything about this song is bizarre and out there.
Well, I think when you went to go do vocals, you were trying to do the Peter Steele thing, because I think we just came off of doing some in that style.
Well, yeah, we had started off, again, this is from the first year of us doing, the first season that we were doing Brunch Weekly right. original singles. So we were doing our fall music, and in fall, you generally listen to heavier music right. and older heavier music. And you guys are both way more so than I will ever be Typo Negative fans.
Right.
And we had done Typo Negative versus Green Day on the original podcast. It's actually the only episode that still exists.
Yes.
And that's up you on our YouTube look, channel. You yeah, can go listen to it with Casey Bergen. Richards?
I believe
at
Mike
Richards.
Is on that.
Yeah, I think Rich is on it. You're on it for a little bit. Yeah, then you dip. Yeah. Zach wasn't on that episode. And Casey was the main guest. I think we had Kevbo. Whoever else might have been in the room, Mikey might have been in the room for that one. I don't really recall. But
yeah,
we
I believe
had,
he was.
I think he was. But we had a real fun time writing this song, and it is one that we opted to not revisit it. We opted to revisit Bitchin' Christmas mostly because we right. had Mead Mark Miller on for a second year in a row. But I wouldn't mind like. A couple of years from now, revisiting same
baby.
Or
it's another kid who
yeah,
made
another
the same
kid
mistake.
Who made the same mistake. Just revisit that story.
Yeah,
and maybe it's
a cool concept.
Maybe we do the story of the kid is now an adult and he remembers and his life's gone.
Or
to
every
shit.
Year he's been doing it.
And now, or he took like a 30-year break and he remembers this story and no one else believes him, so he writes a letter to Satan and Satan shows up again.
That would
and
be
now
cool.
he wants to be like the right hand man of the demon lord.
Well, I think what I was cool. going into yeah. with the vocals is I don't know if it was I don't remember if it was me or Zach who had just been like Grinch the vocals.
Grinch it. Yeah, that was the original, because Peter Steele was like where I went to because we had been playing Typo Negative music weeks prior to get into the mood for some of our fall heavier stuff. But yeah, like we want to do the Grinch, like when you watch the old movie The Grinch yeah. before it was made in with Jim Carrey. The guy who just has that low,
yeah, now that's
booming
the
voice.
Old one, because there's another.
Because there's another yeah. one with Benedict Cumberbatch, and yes. if I had known that at that point, I would have just done Benedict Cumberbatch voice, which is just Alan Rickman's voice, pretty much.
Pretty much, yeah.
I am Benedict Cumberbatch. I am Khan. but I love this song. This is, again, yeah. you say it's your favorite.
It's my favorite Christmas song.
Zach,
yes,
can you choose sure. between your babies? Can you pick your favorite of the Christmas songs?
Kyle. Much like your parents,
yeah.
I can't remember which babies are mine.
Yeah, that's exactly like my parents. You're right. They just love everybody because what if they were mean to a stranger?
I made you all!
And it wound up being one of their children that they just forgot about. There's Carl floating around somewhere.
Carl
and Coraline are just outside somewhere in the cold. And they forgot about them.
Don't forget about Kenny.
No,
either.
Kenny's dead. I actually had an Uncle Kenny. He is dead.
Shit.
Well, I had an Uncle Kenny that became Aunt Catherine, and then he died. She died.
She died.
Either way, let's jump into it. This is Satan Baby with our original logo, our original Houseboat Tommy Lee Jones logo, making a comeback here. So, again, all of these songs are available on YouTube. You can check them out. One day we'll get them on Spotify and other things like that,
yes.
and the whole world will know. But you'll have been there first.
You'll be there first.
You'll have been
that
there.
That means that you get
you
to buy the merch
street
first.
Cred. When we get merch, you get to do that. All right, guys.
You get
so
to
here
have all the
is Satan Baby.
Yes.
Enjoy.
Now in the same time. all into his power.
Guys,
yep.
There you have it. That's all of them. That's all of our Christmas songs. Did we finish all the beer? Was it the last beer?
This was the last beer.
We gotta rate this one.
Oh, I didn't get it from you. We spent all the time not getting it from you. We were too busy enjoying the song. Man. Oh lordy! All right, so this guy that we're drinking now again, Galactica Double IPA. Again, all of these are from Clown Shoes. This is their 12 beers of Christmas. You can so far drink three of them and be all right. I'm not giving this a sip
yet.
Not all right to drive. I'll say the smell of this one is amazing. It smells appropriate for a double IPA. All right, that's good. That one's good.
I enjoy it.
They're good at IPAs is basically what we're learning.
Yes.
But again,
stick with Clown Shoes IPA.
The flavor kind of dissipates after a little bit, so it helps you in the way that you can keep drinking it, and you want to keep going back for another sip when it's good. But it also tricks you in the Lewis Black way of candy corn, you know, like the bad ones. You go, was it that bad? You take another sip. Oh yeah, it was.
Oh,
then it's gone. You're a crazy person. I don't know. What are you guys thinking on this one?
I'm going 85 on this one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
All right, Zach, what are you thinking?
60.
Mm-hmm. I was probably closer to you. I'm gonna give it a 68.
All right.
Don't think it's as good as the previous double IPA that we had. So this is gonna be a fun episode for me to listen back to and grade all of these or get all these grades and put them into our little sheet there.
Yep.
We're gonna be almost like half of the beer we've done all year we've done tonight.
Yes.
So it's going to be maybe I'll just do a collective score at the end and just be like this is all
of the 12 days of
all
Christmas.
All of the 12 days of Christmas special pack.
I think that's good.
That's probably a fair way to do it. That'll help the 12s that we've given and the 85s that we've given out.
I mean realistically it's more or less like, do we recommend doing the 12 beers of Christmas?
Yeah, I would not. I'm just going to say that. I don't recommend spending your money on this. I would recommend going and get Galactica or one of the other IPAs from them.
First with the Yeehaw.
The Yeehaw is great. I like the Wee Heavy. I like the Wee Heavy. But other than that, yeah, you kind of skip it. Really don't touch the quad. That's what I'm the most upset about is because it just didn't do what it should have done there. But yeah, kind of a with them. But either way, that was all of our...
I mean,
our,
if you're planning on getting drunk and want to do it in one night, you're going to get fucked up. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't recommend doing it in one night.
If it's
one
person. You could not drink this whole 12-pack.
If you're one person, but if you're...
Next week, join us live when I find another 12-pack of this and do it all in one night and die. That'll be the way 2020 wraps up with me dead off of 12. We should do the 2020 beers of Christmas next week. And we just do 1,000 of these
shots.
Shots 2020 beer. Shots. 20 beers, 20 shots. Next week, fuck it all. Fuck it all to hell. All right. Now, do join us next week where we will be live next Tuesday, the 29th.
To wrap up this shit year,
and we're gonna already have the plan for the song for next week in order, so it's gonna be a fun one. It's going to be one have to start writing lyrics tomorrow on, because of the way we're gonna be going about this. So again, we'll be back live next week, and then we're gonna take a week off, come back for 2 weeks, take another week off, come back for, you know, it's gonna be weird. It's wintertime, everything gets crazy. You know, always pending the weather. Zach makes his money moving that snow. So, opposed to other people.
Cocaine.
Yeah, as the other people who sell snow. You're just selling.
Disclaimer, I plow the snow.
He plows the snow. He does not sell cocaine. But yeah, we'll be back next week. This is a fun time looking back at the last 2-3 years of writing Christmas music. And at some point, maybe we'll put it all out together as one compilation, and maybe we'll play live next year around Christmas time and do all these songs plus probably just all these songs live. I think we should open it with Zach's You Can Get Fucked for Christmas. Yeah. And then just go right into Satan Baby, and then also close with Satan Baby. Yeah. The whole set should really just be Satan Baby.
I just figured out what we have to do for next year.
Ooh.
Okay, I'm putting this out on the table.
Yeah.
It's an anthology, but it has to be the 12 Days of Christmas.
Yeah. And we're going to do all of our old styles again in one song, and it's going to be 12 days long, right?
Yeah, exactly.
It's going to be a 12-day-long song.
Yeah.
12-day-long
Written
live
in two
stream.
And a half hours.
Ooh. Written in 2.5 hours. So many copies and pastings. It's just like an exponential. Every time you copy and paste, you have to copy the thing before everything you've already copied and pasted, and then paste that, and then copy everything before that, and then paste that, and everything before that, and paste that, and eventually we'll have a 12-day song.
Yeah.
Eventually it'll be like, you know, just that whole trick. Would you rather have $1,000 right now, or, you know, or $1,000 every week, or a penny a day, and every day, you know, you double your penny? Eventually the penny winds up being the better option. That's the type of episode we're going to do next year.
Yeah.
It's going to be weird and confusing, just like that sentence. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in live. Another really fucking long
just
one.
Just like my genitals.
Yeah, probably. I don't know firsthand, but I know secondhand. No.
Left hand.
Left hand's the second hand. We'll be back again, like I said, live next week. In the meantime, go check out all of our past episodes. Go check out all the guys at Moot.TV. Eric putting all these shows out for us. The Derek D Dozen, White Wasabi, once in a while. Not really once in a while. Once every 30 blue moons. And obviously the Let Me Ask You a Question podcast, hosted by Sir Anthony of the Angels, Anthony DeAngelis, with Gregaman and EJ5000 there. As always, a big thank you to Mr. Justin Olimpato for getting everything organized and put together for us tonight.
No, it was good revisiting this.
It was fun. It was good. It's going to be a hard one to listen back to for me because, again, we're just pushing for the 3-hour. 3 weeks ago, Zach jokingly said we should just do 4-hour shows. And since you said that, we've done 2 3-hour shows. Yeah. So we're inching our way towards there. Right. We're just fuck it all. We're fucking it all to hell. 2020, it's all gone to shit.
That's it.
In addition to Justin Olimpato, thank you to Mr. Zachary.
Christmas!
Storming. All right, guys, for Kyle Mocha, One Shut Up, I am your host, Kyle Mocha. We will see you next week. Have a very Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
This episode will be dropping on iTunes after Christmas, so we hope you already had a very Merry Christmas.
Hopefully it was safe, everything.
Yeah, stay safe, stay home if you can, and keep your gatherings to a minimum, but we all know it's tough.
Keep positive, guys.
A lot of shit's going on. Don't need to be adding to negativity in the world. Just keep your head up, your head straight, and just fucking... Live as best as you can, guys. We'll see you next week. Here is our closing theme song to close us out, as always.
Jerry Lewis, Jeff Buckley.
Mood.tv.
There's nothing more egomaniacal than singing the theme music for your own show. Who am I? Kelsey Grammer. If I could only drink like him, we're gonna write a new one every week. Some will be solid, some will be weak. We're gonna write a new one every week.